welcome to Homorazzi. This is our 100th episode.
Yay! And we have a studio audience!
Yeah. For the first time ever.
That's a fake laugh track. We all know there's someone out there.
We have champagne, we have new cups. We've come a long way.
Have we?
We have. 100 episodes. The first few episodes were
so awkward.
Sorry, your hair is much longer.
You guys are still awkward,
I know,
both of you.
So
just
awkward.
Terrible.
Okay, go. My hair is much longer. Yes, I'm also much thinner.
Yes.
And I don't wear V-necks with vests anymore.
Thank God.
That was like my thing.
That was the worst.
I was gonna wear the first outfit that I wore today, but I put it on and it was like
Lucy Goose.
Like a parachute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've stopped grabbing my junk in the middle of this.
But you still don't wear underwear.
I never have, never will. Yeah. So, no, I used to grab my penis, I can say that word, right? All the time when we were on here and I got dinged for it a lot. So I've stopped doing that.
Yeah.
I've grown. They put a cup in front of me and put liquor in it, so I'm all good to go.
It's a little distracting.
What have you done that's different?
Nothing.
You shrunk a little bit.
I shrunk a little bit. No, I have a booster seat. Halfway through all of the filming, we started to put cushions underneath.
We got messages about how short you were. It was kind of
I need to see over the table.
He was like this. He was like, hi.
No, you stole a boyfriend. You have this sneaky little boyfriend that hasn't dumped you yet, so that's really exciting. So
thanks, Adam.
We got there with him.
So what's new with you?
I had a really bad sexual experience a couple weeks
ago.
Let's
hear about it.
It was so bizarre. Like, I was out one night and then this adorable little thing was there. Then me and my, but like, it was nothing. It was like innocent flirting. And then me and my friend Jared walked home. We got some mini eggs and whatever. And then we were walking home.
So you stopped at the corner market to buy Cadbury mini eggs.
Not with the guy, with my friend. Like, we had separated.
Just in general.
Yeah.
Okay.
Who doesn't?
Maybe at Easter or something.
No, girl, they're cheaper when it's not Easter. Hello.
Too late, a pride body, no cake.
Anyway, so then me and Jared were walking home and we turned
Jared
the corner.
And
Jared and I were in the room. And we turned the corner, and then that boy was there. Let's call him, I can't give his real name. Let's call him Joe. Joe and Joe's friend were there, and I didn't know, but Joe's friend was hitting on Jared earlier. So we were like three sheets to the wind and kept walking, and then Joe's friend like ran after us two blocks, and me and Jared were like, oh my God, are we gonna get killed? What's happening? What's Jared and I, So then it was just this very awkward like four-person conversation, and it was like 4:30 in the morning, and I was like, I'm going home.
Ooh.
So then I just was walking home, and then Joe followed me, and then we went home and like started making out a little bit, and it was just really bizarre because he was so drunk. Like, so drunk to the point that I kind of felt like...
You were raping him?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
You can say that. He wasn't actually.
I felt like, I don't know. I'm like, okay, let's just go to bed. So then like, we fell asleep. Smallest dick I've ever seen in my life. And then when...
Tiny Joe.
When
mini
he
eggs.
Woke up...
Mini eggs.
Mini eggs. You got a mini egg down there.
And then when he woke up, it was just this really weird thing. He's like, oh my God, where am I? How did I get here? I was like, okay, it's time for you to go.
You and your mini eggs gotta go.
You need to go. So then it was just very awkward. It was just not.
Your hair is like all up in a towel.
It was. My hair was up. I sleep with it up
Erica
in a
Badu.
Butt. It was just a very, very weird thing. Smallest dick ever.
Did he hey, I remember this or?
Oh, I forgot to tell you. The next day, he texted me. He's like, I'm
Where did you exchange numbers after this point? Like, hey, if you need to call the police, like, here's my
right?
number.
Oh my God.
No, and then he was like, I'm so sorry. And then he said, can you please not tell anyone about this? So now I've told everyone.
Oh.
Sorry about it.
You misunderstood the assignment.
I really don't care. The second someone tells me not to, I tell everybody.
Oh, lesson learned, kids. Don't tell anything to these guys.
I'll tell you that.
Well, no, you could tell us stuff, but don't tell us not to say something, especially like, obviously he was like embarrassed for whatever reason, whether it was drunk or whether he was drunk or whether he came home with me or whatever.
It was your hair.
But he has a small dick, so I don't really care.
Wow. That's an update. Patrick, you? What do you have going on?
Nothing like that. I've been busy...
Being in a relationship.
Oh my
God,
a little
no
bit.
Onto this.
No, we've been hanging
Taking
out a lot
really,
more.
Really tacky Instagram photos. Like, good, but they're tacky.
Well, because I've gone on a trip with him, and, like, I'll just, like, be the person in the photos, so then he can, like, have someone...
You're dating him for his Instagram followers, right?
Oh
like, we can
God,
say this.
Oh my God, no.
How many does he have?
I don't know.
500,000. 500,000.
Oh,
500,000.
Oh my God.
So you're dating him so that he'll tag you in and you'll become famous? I just want to put this in like a realistic perspective.
Don't be shy. I would.
No, this is ridiculous. No, this is like the first person I've connected with in years and years, and so that's what it's about.
Okay.
And as someone who's been in a relationship longer than 2 months, I can attest to that.
Your four failed engagements is what you're gonna throw into
my
face.
Oh wow! They've gone from 2 to 3 to now to 4. Lie a little bit more, Adam.
Look for the rings. There's a picture.
Oh my God. But I was also gonna say like we're full into summer now and it's getting a little bit stressful. In terms of like, well, first of all, it's like everyone's birthday in our friend group.
Yeah.
And then Pride's coming up and there's like all these softball and soccer tournaments.
Lots
so,
of sports, yeah.
I love how like it's getting stressful. Like we have so many birthdays and pride.
This is our life.
Well, sports.
Normally like, this is you. This is you in previous like pride years. Like, oh my God, you guys, I'm wearing black because I have pride coming up and I'm like so tired.
It's in 3 months.
You have no idea what I go through because
well, you don't have any idea what I go through. Anyways, moving on.
Well, yeah, with you. Speaking of pride.
Me. So this is our tough lives. Yeah. I went from Seattle Pride for 4 days with a nice little rafting day in the middle, coming home for 6 hours, repacking, going to Toronto for 8 days or something ridiculous. Ooh. I mean, I've never end-to-end, pride-to-pride, ass-to-assed it, but it was like a lot going on. It was a totally fun time. The weather turned out perfect.
Yeah.
Seattle, blast. Amazing friends down there. Rat friend Cam, all our friends, great hanging out with them. Toronto, never been there before. Weather was perfect. 27 degrees, everything was good.
Especially there, because once it goes over 30,
you're done.
Yeah.
Humid, you hate your life, everything's terrible. Parties were great. I did nothing. I didn't see CN Tower. I didn't go to Market Square.
Did you see it like in the distance?
I saw a tower.
Then you saw it. It's there. It's not going.
He's not sure if it's CN Tower.
I was near City Hall. I had a great view of that stupid Toronto sign. Someone's like, take a picture. I said, take this. Like, I'm not doing any of that shit. What I did do, though, was go to all the parties I could, experience them, see our friends DJ. Nick Bertozzi was DJing. Yeah. Del Stamp was DJing. Had a great time seeing them. The interesting part was what happened at the parade, though. So I want to kind of move into this, if you guys have seen this, heard
about
this.
Yeah, okay, so now we're rolling into gossip.
This
so
is our gossip update. So, I mean, Trudeau was in the parade.
Great.
Huge news. First sitting prime minister, attended a gay parade, blah, blah, blah. That's awesome news. Mm-hmm. The big thing that happened is Black Lives Matters were, they're this group, obviously, throughout, but they have a contingent in Toronto, and they were an honorary guest. So they had this
Prime Marshal. They were Grand Marshal.
Oh, there you go. So during the parade, at a certain point, they sat down. They did a sit-in for 25 minutes. Because the theme this year was, you can sit with us, instead of the Mean Girls, you can't. So this is an inclusivity thing. The point is, they were saying that where LGBT rights have been moving forward like crazy, and they're all getting fought for, and this is a celebration of that, Black rights and other Indigenous and people of color rights haven't been moving forward. So particularly in Toronto, they still do this like stop and search thing, like at an inordinate rate for Black guys in communities. They get stopped. What's your ID? What are you doing? All this kind of stuff at rates that don't make sense and it's not right. And they've tried to apologize for it, but things aren't getting moved ahead enough. So they wanted to sit down and say things need to like change here. And I want to hear your opinion on this.
I loved it. I thought it was so punk rock. I thought this was political theater at its best.
Yeah.
That they weren't going to get up until the executive director
signed off this agreement
and all of these points. A lot of them were totally normal, like hire more Black trans women and for Pride, et cetera, et cetera. The one that everyone's kind of freaking out over is
the police.
The police. The police, one of their demands was the police are no longer allowed to be involved in Pride or the parade, or any community tents or whatever. So everyone was kind of like really surprised by that because for a group that is wanting inclusivity, they're kind of excluding some, blah, 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 whatever. This is the way I saw this. I thought this was political theater at its best. Like, they halted this parade, and if they had actually thought that that agreement would be legally binding, I don't think that they thought that. Like, it was signed under duress. I'm sure there's something that, like, it's not gonna hold up in court. But what they wanted was they wanted the optics of the executive director of Pride stopping this thing, him signing it, and then starting it again. What they're gonna get from this is a conversation. Whether or not any of those terms are actually gonna be held up, I don't know. It may happen, it may not. I just thought it was really cool.
It was so punk rock though.
It was so cool. Like, just for them to stop it and these like beautiful women with their braids, like just screaming, oh my God, I wish I was there.
The pictures
were
actually pretty
serious. It was incredible.
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna take a short break and be back with music. Welcome back, we're moving on to music now, and first up is the comeback video from Fergie, it's called MILF.
Is she a mom? Even
what a comeback!
Well, she hasn't been doing anything for a long
time. She's a mother. Every woman in this video is a mother.
Okay, yes. I needed to research that.
Yeah, they're all mothers, okay?
I'm now behind this video.
Love the song.
Yeah, of course you do.
Love the video.
Yeah, of course you do.
I mean, it's no. I love Fergie. I always said if I died and come back, I'd either want to be Jennifer Lopez or Fergie.
Because they're huge.
I don't know, because they're just really, like, I find them extremely sexy.
Yeah, but she had that, like, tragic song. Didn't she try to come back with something that, like,
oh, LA,
LA
or something?
Oh, Tokyo.
Yeah, no, this is the comeback we want, and I'm going to say, Summer Song 2016.
Are you?
100%.
What?
She was 100%.
She was teasing another song before that. No, I think I'm gonna like even more than this one.
No, this song is hot. The video is hot. Everyone is obsessed with this. She looks amazing. Yes. I love the Bon Jovi Slippery When Wet, like Luke and the Milk. Oh, I love it.
Yeah. I love that she sticks to her old like style. Like she, you know, there's a lot of rappers that have come after her.
She's not really a rapper. She's like a sing-talker, but then there are... A talk singer? Sing talker?
Sing talker sounds amazing. Whatever. Go with it.
But then, like, there are parts in that song where she starts singing, and you kind of forget that she actually has a really great voice.
Of course, yeah.
I love her. I love Fergie. This song is everything!
All right, next up is the latest from Rihanna. This one's called Sledgehammer.
I'm bracing for the pain, and I am letting go. I'm using all my strength to get out of this wound. I hit a wall. I thought that I would hurt myself.
Oh.
Well, this is for Star Trek.
Don't give me that.
No?
Give me the original Sledgehammer. This was terrible.
I loved it.
No, no. I understand that, like, I'm assuming, like, the credits are gonna be coming up during
this. Yeah, this is not.
Whatever.
Okay, the song is.
Boring.
No, it's not boring. It's actually incredible. The song is written by Sia, and you can really tell her influence in this. I think you don't like it because it's sung by Rihanna. I think if this was sung by Sia, you would love it. This song is, it's totally true.
What I will say, I preferred her in that stupid box that we talked about like 2 weeks ago.
As that's because you like that song.
I just, the song was fine. This song was boring.
I don't think the song is boring. I think Rihanna can't sing.
Okay.
And it hurts, I was watching this video and I'm like, she's such a perfect example of like the machine making a star because she really can't sing. Even when she's like auto-tuned. No.
She was performing on the billboards and she sang in like one of those boxes, I think, or whatever, but she was singing that slower song that was more of like a...
And she didn't sound like a dying goat?
No, she sounded amazing. It was a slower song.
No.
No, you, I disagree.
You can disagree all you want.
No, we talked about it. We talked about it and you thought it was like one of the best performances of the night.
I would never have said Rihanna singing live is the best performance.
It was one of them.
I would never say that.
I can't believe you guys are arguing with each other. This never happens.
No, I would never say that because she can't sing live.
She did on that one.
Whatever.
You're both wrong. The song was terrible.
No, I like the song. The song is good for the movie, and she looks really cute in it, blah, blah, blah.
What does she look cutely? She looks like some busted-ass Klingon. I don't know what's going on in this video. They just, like, painted all over
her. She's trying to look Star Trek-ish.
Star Trek-ish. I've got that Star Trek-ish look of mine going on in the middle of the freaking desert. Like, boring.
Next up is the latest video from Years and Years. This one's called Worship.
Can I still make it right? Can I be what you like? Can I keep up this fight? That you never know why I need your control.
He is like the epitome of a rock star to me.
Yeah.
He's not cute. He's too skinny for me, but I watched him on stage and I wanted to like throw my panties at him. He is so sexy when he performs. I don't know what it is. Like there's some people just have that and some people don't. He's so fun live.
Yeah.
He's super flirty. He's gay.
What
right?
made you Obviously. Go? Because I think when I talked about him last year, you were not into this at all.
Oh, it was a free ticket. I thought I would go and I heard a song and I was like, oh, this song is kind of cute. Okay. And so I went and it was a great show. Like. I'm not a fan, right? But like the people at the Commodore were like fans. It was a great show. And the song is cute. It's very them. Like it's very their sound. It's very, you know, how they.
And he's like a performer in the
he's
video.
He's a great performer.
I f***ing love this video. Like I actually usually hate the music.
I thought you were gonna say this was too artsy.
Not at all. Like it's, I mean, obviously it's the story like of gay prostitutes and whatever. Yeah. And this is what they're going through. Told in this like dancing fashion and all the dancing stuff that's coming up these days, I'm really liking and appreciating people who actually do it well and telling a story through it. And he's just some like random twink who's whatever, but he's
so
interesting,
sexy,
engaging, and sexual is how I would put it. Thing. So like, it just brings you in. The story is well told. I thought it was so good. And is he like dating the guy from the other thing, like from the youth or something like that? Someone told me the Years and Years guy is dating the other gay guy. God knows why. I think it's great. I think he's got a cool voice, and I never like the stuff he put up. So I'm excited.
Well, let's move on to movies now. The first trailer is called Mike and Dave Need Wedding Dates. Take a look.
Mom and Dad, what's going on here?
Over the years at our family gathering, you two show up and you ruin it. I want you to bring a date to
your sister's
wedding. We don't want you showing up stag and riling each other up.
We don't rile each other up!
We never get riled up!
We'll shape up for you, Jeannie.
So these guys have been around doing comedies now for like 3 years.
And they all suck.
Well, I don't know. I like the first, like, whatever that roommates thing was, or whatever the college thing with Zac Efron being the guy who takes off his shirt and tries to hook up with everyone. This is just another one of those things, though.
Yeah.
So the problem is, though, I like all these actors on their own.
It's a
like,
great mixture of actors.
Like, Aubrey is f***ing hilarious, and
Kendrick is amazing.
Doing her own thing. So it's just, it's like, annoying kids being annoying at an annoying wedding, like, yeah. I don't think it's gonna be very good.
I don't really wanna see this movie. I don't think I'll ever see this movie. Yeah. I've never seen one of these movies.
I do wanna see this movie.
I know.
Of course you do.
I love the people in it, like Adam said, and I think it will do pretty well.
I think, yes, 20 to 30 year olds who are drunk
and stoned. It's going to bomb. It's not gonna make any money.
What we will review to this later.
No, I don't think it's gonna make as much money as people think it's gonna make. It may just break even.
Let's move on to the next film. This one's called The Secret Life of Pets.
Max! This is Duke. He's going to be your brother.
This is my apartment now.
And my new bed!
Ah! Oh, Duke, Katie's gonna be so upset when she sees that. Katie's gonna flip out.
It's just one vase.
Is it, Duke? Is it?
Oh, that's a shame.
This looks hilarious, and I cannot wait to go see. What are you rolling your eyes for?
The Secret Lives of Pets.
It's
are
so
you kidding
funny.
Me?
Well, do you have a pet?
No, I don't have a pet.
That's
I have
probably
plants.
Why you can't like relate to it, right?
Because I don't have a pet.
I want to see it just because I have pets too, and there's a wiener dog in it, and that makes me want to watch it.
Oh, the one that puts itself under a blender because that's a thing?
No, in one of the previews, he's like burrowing under a blanket, and my dog does the exact same thing, and I really want to see this. And the last trailer for today is Ghostbusters.
Somebody is trying to unleash the dead on New York City, and we may be the only ones who can save it.
Why am I operating the untested nuclear laser?
You have the longest arms.
Fire!
Oh, something big is gonna happen.
I think the word we're looking for is apocalypse.
I need to talk about this movie for a sec. Why does everyone hate this movie?
They're getting flack
for
this.
This movie is the worst reviewed movie on YouTube, like by ratio. People
well, the first
hate
trailer was...
it. Why? I thought the first trailer was great. Like, I think what's happening right now is all of these fanboys and fangirls are like, these aren't my Ghostbusters, da 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 da. But we have to remember that this isn't for adults. This movie is now geared to kids and, like, especially young girls.
Ghostbusters, young girls?
Well, it's a cast of
the girls
four
out there
women.
Who want a Ghostbust, and they, like, need heroes.
No, but you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not about the 30 to 40 year old nerd anymore. It's about the young kids.
Fair enough.
Of course, fair enough.
I love that you guys are arguing today. This makes
me
so
I don't know what he's talking about. Not
no,
I'm overheating.
Ghostbusters was one of my favorite movies as a kid. So
I actually don't think I've seen it.
I watched it over and over, and I would go to the rental store and like rent the same movie. I don't know why they didn't just buy it from me.
I feel like you told us that.
I know.
Your stories
like,
are also
I'm
boring.
So excited to see this movie.
Well, you love the actresses in this as well.
Yes,
so that's like a huge deal.
Well, but that's the thing I don't understand is like these four actresses are four hilarious comedians.
Yeah.
So I don't understand why people aren't attaching to this.
I don't know. It's just, it's gone from guys to women. And it's gone like kitschier, I think. Although back in the day,
you know what's gonna happen? This movie's gonna come out. It's going to be the funniest thing that we've seen.
Do you think so?
I absolutely think so.
I'm not
bad
against
trailer,
this.
Good movie. Good trailer, bad movie.
I don't agree with that. But I want this to do well. I just, from the jokes I've been seeing, I think it's just gonna be a little silly and not like funny. If you can draw the line between those two things. And I want to see a funny movie. I don't want to see a silly movie.
All right. On that note, that's all we have for movies. When we come back, we're gonna move on to some social media and then TV. Welcome back. We're moving on to our social media portion of the show where we check our Facebook feeds and talk about what the first thing that we see is.
Okay, okay. I got one.
Okay.
So this is cute. Because you know when you add someone new and like all their shit just blows up your wall? Like they're like, now you need to know all about this person.
Mm-hmm.
So the most recent person I added was my pride boyfriend from Toronto.
You had a pride boyfriend?
Whoa!
This is news to me.
Yeah.
I need names, age.
How many days?
Social security number.
37.
Yeah,
we'll go with Matt.
How many days?
His name is Matt. His name is French, so his name's Matt. And we met second night of me being there, and we were.
Wow, that's a long time.
It was a long time, and he's a really sweet guy.
This is your second longest relationship.
Hold on, I need more
first
details.
Most
I need more details.
What
about
do you mean? He's a bottom.
So you, okay,
which
so
is great.
I don't care about that. So you met him on Tuesday.
Yes.
How many days did you spend with him during your stay there?
Here's the thing. We kept running into each other. Toronto's f***ing huge. All
oh
these
my god, it was fake! You were living in a rom-com.
Like, I went to the Black Eagle because I wanted to see our friend Dom, who was bartending. He was great and amazing fun. And I'm like, I'm just gonna go by myself. That's what I'm gonna do. In a line, he shows up right behind me. And I'm like, there are a million people in this city. I know no one at this party. I would've talked to no one. He shows up.
Did
we spent the whole night together.
Did you hold hands?
We had sex in the back room of the Black Eagle.
But I'm just saying, did you hold hands
at
one point?
Oh, while I was him and held his hand in the back room of the Eagle. There was this 400-pound guy watching us. He loved it. Like, it was so romantic.
No, keep going.
So we kept meeting. And then, like, we're going down the street, and I'm, like, leaving a party, and he's on his way home, and we're kind of in the same direction. We meet his friend. We're walking. He drops.
Did you hold his hand when you were walking?
Yeah.
Oh! That's what I wanted to hear.
He showed me how to get a shawarma, and he held my hand when we were doing it. It was quite cute.
Yeah.
Well, I got a shawarma and went home and ate it at my hotel, but yes.
Where does he live?
He lives in Toronto. He's from Montreal.
When is he coming to visit?
Yeah,
I said if he came, I would show him a very good time. So it'll be, anyway, he's very sweet. It was.
Are you gonna keep in touch?
Yes, I touched him right before we got here. Like, it's all fine. So anyways, on my feet.
Oh my God, you're so in love.
Yes, he's never seen the show.
Yes, he said yes.
He's never seen the show, so he'll see this. So I'm gonna make sure he watches this.
Oh, wow.
Yep, you guys.
What about you?
Mine is.
Baby picture.
No, it's even probably worse than that. This Canada Post thing that's been happening.
Well, that's not worse. That's very important.
Okay, well, this Canada Post thing obviously affects my business. We ship a lot of stuff out, and it's like been super annoying. We've been shipping stuff by alternative methods through FedEx and all this stuff. Just
cha-ching, cha-ching.
Well, I know, and it's way more expensive to do it that way.
It's interesting because you hear this, and you're like, I don't care. Like, I'm not an 85-year-old woman. I don't get mail, but actual companies use
this.
We get mail every single day.
Yeah, and in Canada, though, like, in terms of, like, compared to the U.S. where they use UPS and FedEx for everything, for example.
Because it's way cheaper.
Yeah, here, the most inexpensive way is Canada Post still. So it just sucks.
I hope they don't go on strike, especially since I ordered some new Sailor Moon toys that I really want to get before
my birthday. What really matters here, isn't it? Sailor Moon toys.
Yeah. Things are hard.
Things are so hard.
We are stressed.
If I don't get my new keychains, I'm going to lose.
Tell me, go to your Facebook.
I actually have nothing on my Facebook other than the stuff from Toronto, Pride, a bunch of wigs.
Tell me about wigs.
I mean, I don't really, it's people are making wigs for Pride.
Oh. Like our Pride.
Yeah.
How do you make a wig?
Well, how do you think wigs are made? Do you think they just pop out?
Yeah, but like, people in our city can make these wigs.
Yeah, no, you get hair and you like make it on a net and then it's just like this.
Can we chop that
like
up?
Like drag queens are making wigs?
Yeah.
Oh. All right, well, let's move on to TV now. The first show we're going to talk about is season 2 of Mr. Robot. Take a look.
You not knowing what you did or didn't do, our infinite loop of insanity.
I will follow my dreams no matter what.
I'm sorry, my dear. This is all in your head.
I have to say I'm so interested at how people got into this. Like, I watched it right away.
I'll tell you exactly. Golden Globes.
We watched it before.
I watched it.
No, you
I'm
watched
surprised
it before.
That people, like, blew up
That's
on this.
That's what I'm saying.
It's
because
dark,
it won.
It's weird, it's, like, internet-y, it's sci-fi, it's crazy.
It was on the Golden Globes, That's and everybody was talking about it, and it won all of these awards.
So buzz factor and
yes,
awards.
Yes, like, we actually, me and my roommate watched the Golden Globes, and I said, Mia, we have two shows to watch. You want to watch Mr. Robot, or do you want to watch something else? I don't remember. She's like, why don't you watch Mr. Robot? It seems like one of your shows that I'm not going to pay attention to. Within 3 minutes, she was in the kitchen. She's like, you need to pause this. I was like, why? She's like, I need to watch this. Well, you watched the whole thing.
Of course you did.
Like, we actually
your
had
Sunday
to.
Sunday night thing?
We had to, no, we had to, like, go to bed at 2 a.m., but, like, we finished it the next day. This show is probably one of the best shows on television with Unreal. 100%. It's so, you don't like it?
I do. I liked it from the beginning. I'm just a crazy swim fan girl over it.
Oh, it's so good.
I mean, one thing I think is cute is that they did the money stuff all around town and friends of ours, like Maddie was.
And me and Matt did it.
Did you find?
Yeah, I found $50.
They like made money. Like, you all found money?
Yes.
Where is my money, Mr. Robot?
Well, your parents had to be downtown.
Your parents bring it to your door.
Oh, thanks, Mom and Dad. I just like, they're viral. They're new. It's hitting a good age of people and like anti-establishment and anti-big corporations and stuff. Like, they're smart about it. I don't quite get the huge fascination with it.
Let's move on to the next show. This one's new on Netflix and it's called Brahmin Naman.
Cheers.
I don't really drink
nonsense. Everybody drinks.
He wouldn't know, baby. He's never done it.
So this one looks really cute. Like, you are never gonna watch it. It's cute. It's like a different culture, different world, different like time almost.
But what is this show about?
It's about a guy who's brilliant and can do all these things right, but
he's
can't
a virgin?
Connect with a girl. No, it's not a virgin thing. It's
yes,
a guy
it is.
He's... No, yes, he is a virgin, but that's not the point. It's someone who can't connect socially, even though intellectually he's like advanced beyond stages. Like, it's just a funny little intersect.
But the show, I mean, it's about, like, him and his friends go
trying to get him laid.
Yeah.
That's what I got from it. And, like, he ties his penis to, like, the fan and is, like, that's essentially what I thought the show was, is this guy needs to get off. That's
so that like is the, what it's about.
The 20-year-old Indian virgin.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's move on to the next one, which is called Stranger Things, also on Netflix.
Later. See you tomorrow. Do you really think it was a coincidence that we found her at the same place where Will disappeared? Something is going on here!
What the hell?
She knows about Will!
What is this show and why am I so into it?
Are you?
Oh, it's, I watched this trailer and I was like vibrating for this to come out. I need to know everything about this. I love that Winona Ryder's in it. And there's parts of it that made me feel like it was really scary, but then like the kids are involved. So I felt like it was whimsical. I don't know. It just, this show, I feel like I'm gonna watch this in a day.
It's Netflix. Kids get killed on Netflix. So like, I think something could really happen with the show. Like, I get that like, hey, is this a mix of funny or like or Goonies this, meets like, I don't know.
I kind of felt like it was a little Stand By Me in there.
But
like,
there's some shaky points. And you're like, is this gonna be like a terrifying thing? I'm hoping it's freaky as and I do
want
to watch it too,
and I don't know where this came from. I'm so glad you put this on because I had no idea about this, and it's all coming out July 15th.
It's another one from Netflix. Netflix is on a roll, I think.
But when they peak, so let's see.
All right, well, that's all we have for today's show. Thank you guys for tuning in for our 100th episode, and we hope to see you for 100 more.
Yay. Oh, that don't work!
Oh my god, I didn't even see that coming at all.
Oh, wow.
He's kind of late.
I did not see that coming at all.
Oh, my champagne.
Oh, you didn't see the like, giant cannon?
You just like threw champagne in my eye.
I'm getting to that one.
Oh, it's mixing with his sweat. It's burning. It's menopause juice. It is no.